We are going to perform circumflexion with universal goniometer. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Goniometer alignment, fulcrum over the external auditory meatus. Stable arm, perpendicular to the ground. Movable arm, parallel to the tip of nose. As the patient bends the head, movable arm move with the movement. Normal range of motion is 0 to 45 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend the head forward and downwards with keeping the trunk straight. Therapist may observe the trick movement like flexion of the thoracic spine and avoid them. We are going to perform cervical flexion with tap. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Tap alignment, one mark placed over the tip of chin and other on sternal notch. Measure the distance between tip of chin and sternal notch. Instruction to the patient, bend the head forward and downward with keeping the trunk straight. Measure the difference between at the beginning and at the end of range of motion. Normal range 1 to 4.3 cm. We are going to perform cervical flexion with inclinometer. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Inclinometer alignment, place inclinometer firmly on the top of the head. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend the head forward and downwards with keeping the trunk straight. At the end of range of motion, read and record the degrees on the dials of inclinometer. Now we are going to perform cervical flexion with double inclinometer. Patient position, sitting position with thoracic and lumbar spine well supported by back of chair. Inclinometer alignment, place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T1 vertebra. Place second inclinometer on the top of the head. Both inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. The examiner should maintain both inclinometer in place throughout the motion. Instruction to the patient, ask the patient to bend the head forward and keeping the trunk straight. At the end of the motion, read the degrees indicated by both inclinometer. The range of motion is the difference between the readings of the two inclinometers. Normal range of motion is 0 to 50 degree. We are going to perform cervical extension with universal goniometer. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Goniometer alignment, fulcrum over the external auditory meatus, stable arm perpendicular to the ground, movable arm parallel to the tip of nose. As the patient bends the head, movable arm move with the movement. Normal range of motion is 0 to 50 degree. Instruction to the patient, move the head in extension. We are going to perform cervical extension with tap. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Tap alignment, place one mark over the middle of the tip of chin and other on the lower edge of sternal notch. Measure the distance between tip of chin and sternal notch. Instruction to the patient, bend the head in extension. Patient's mouth remain closed during the motion. Measure the difference between at the beginning and at the end of range of motion. We are going to perform cervical extension with inclinometer. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Inclinometer alignment, place the inclinometer firmly on the top of the head. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, raise chin first and then move the head backward as far as possible without moving the trunk. At the end of range of motion, read and record the degrees indicated by the fluid in inclinometer. We are going to perform cervical lateral flexion with universal goniometer. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Goniometer alignment, fulcrum over the spinous process of the C7 vertebra. Stable arm with the spinous process of thoracic vertebrae so that the arm perpendicular to the ground. Movable arm with the dorsal midline of the head. Normal range of motion is 0 to 22 degree. Instruction to the patient, move the head into lateral flexion while keeping the trunk straight. Now we are going to perform cervical lateral flexion with TAP. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. TAP alignment, place marks on the subject's mastoid process and on the lateral tip of the acromion process and measure the distance. Normal range from 10.7 to 12.9 cm. Instruction to the patient, move the head into lateral flexion while keeping the trunk straight. Measure the distance between the two marks at the end of the motion. Now we are going to perform cervical lateral flexion with inclinometer. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Inclinometer alignment. Place the inclinometer firmly on the top of the subject's head. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, move the head into lateral flexion while keeping the trunk straight. At the end of range of motion, read and record the degrees indicated by the fluid in inclinometer. Now we are going to perform cervical extension with double inclinometer. Patient position, sitting position with thoracic and lumbar spine well supported by back of chair. Inclinometer alignment, place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T1 vertebra. Place second inclinometer on the top of the head. Both inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. The examiner should maintain both inclinometer in place throughout the motion. Instruction to the patient, move head into extension while keeping the trunk straight. At the end of the motion, read the degrees indicated by both inclinometer. The range of motion is the difference between the readings of the two inclinometer. Now we are going to perform cervical rotation with universal goniometer. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. Goniometer alignment, fulcrum over the center of the cranial aspect of the head. Stable arm, parallel to an imaginary line between the two acromial processes. Movable arm with the tip of the nose. Normal range of motion, 49 degree to the left and 51 degree to the right. Instruction to the patient, roll the head into rotation. Now we are going to perform cervical rotation with TAP. Patient position, high sitting with thoracic and lumbar spine supported by back of chair. TAP alignment, place mark on the tip of the chin and acromion process and measure the distance. Instruction to the patient, roll the head into rotation. Measure the distance between the two marks at the end of the motion. Normal range of motion from 11 to 13.2 cm. Now we are going to perform cervical rotation with inclinometer. Patient position, supine lying with head in neutral position. Inclinometer alignment, place the inclinometer in the middle of the subject's forehead. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, roll the head into rotation. The range of motion can be read on the inclinometer at the end of the range of motion. There are three methods to measure thoracolumbar flexion. First is TAP measurement. Patient position, standing with feet together. TAP alignment, place the one mark over the spinous process of T1 and second on the S2 vertebrae. Align the tap between two spinous processes and record the distance at the starting of range of motion. Instruction to the patient, bend forward while keeping the arm relaxed and the knee straight. Hold the tap in place. Record the distance at the end of range of motion. Measure the difference between the starting and ending of range of motion. Normal range is 4 inch or 10 cm. Now second one is double inclinometer. Patient position standing with knee straight. Inclinometer alignment. Place the one inclinometer over the spinous process of T1 and second inclinometer over the spinous process of S2. Both inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend forward while keeping the both arm relaxed and knee straight. At the end of the motion, record the value of the both inclinometer. The difference between two inclinometer indicate the amount of the thoracolumbar flexion. Normal value is 60 degree. Now third method is fingertip to floor. Patient position, standing with feet together and knee straight. Instruction to the patient, slowly bend forward as far as possible in an attempt to touch the floor with the fingers while keeping the knee extended and feet together. Measurement. At the end of the motion, measure the perpendicular distance between the tip of the middle finger and the floor, either with the tap or ruler. Normal range is 0.1 cm. There are three methods to measure thoracolumbar extension. First is tap measurement. Patient position, standing with feet together and knee straight. Tap alignment. Place one mark over the spinous process of T1 vertebrae and another at S2 vertebrae. Align the tap, measure the distance between two spinous processes and record the distance at the starting of range of motion. Instruction to the patient, bend backward as far as possible while keeping the arm relaxed and the knee straight. Hold the tap in place. Record the distance at the end of range of motion. Measure the difference between at the starting and ending of range of motion. The therapist should look that no posterior pelvic tilt is done by patient while extending back. Second one is double inclinometer. Patient position, standing with feet together and knee straight. Placement of inclinometer. Place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T1 and second inclinometer over the S2 vertebrae. Both inclinometers are adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend backward as far as possible while keeping the both arm relaxed and knee straight. Avoid rig movement by patient. No posterior pelvic tilt should happen. At the end of motion, record the value on both inclinometers. The difference between two inclinometers indicate the amount of thoracolumbar extension. Normal value is 25 degree. Third one is prone push-up. We are going to perform thoracolumbar extension with tap. Patient position, lie on the stomach on a plinth with palms of the hands positioned at shoulder level. Place a belt over the pelvis to prevent it from lifting up of the supporting surface. Tap alignment. Measure the distance from the sternal notch to the supporting surface. Tap measure is vertical and record the measurement. Instruction to the patient. Extend elbows to raise the trunk up off the table and extend the thoracolumbar spine. At the end of the motion, measure the distance between sternal notch and supporting surface. Tap measure should be vertical. There are four methods to measure thoracolumbar lateral flexion. First is universal goniometer. Patient position, standing with feet flat on the floor with the knee extended. Goniometer alignment, fulcrum, over the posterior aspect of the spinous process of S2 vertebrae. Stable arm, perpendicular to the ground. Movable arm, posterior aspect of the spinous process of C7 vertebrae. As the patient bends, the movable arm moves with the movement. Normal range 0 to 35 degree to each side. Instruction to the patient. Bend the trunk on one side while keeping the arm in a relaxed position at the side of the body. We are going to perform thoracolumbar lateral flexion with use of double inclinometer. Patient position, standing. Placement of inclinometer. Place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T1 vertebrae and second inclinometer over the spinous process of S2. Both inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient. Bend to the side as far as possible while keeping both knees straight and both feet flat on the ground. At the end of the range of motion, record the values of both inclinometer. The difference between two inclinometer indicate the amount of thoracolumbar lateral flexion range of motion. Third one is fingertip to thigh for thoracolumbar lateral flexion. Patient position, standing with back against the wall and shoulder and arm hanging freely at the side of the body. Place the mark on the thigh at the level of middle finger. Instruction to the patient, bend to the side as far as possible while keeping the back and shoulder against the wall and both feet flat on the ground with knee extended. At the end of the motion, make a second mark on the leg level with the tip of the middle finger. The distance between the two marks is the value for thoracolumbar lateral flexion. Normal range is 21 cm. We are going to perform thoracolumbar rotation with universal goniometer. Patient position, sit on a chair without a back support. Goniometer alignment. Fulcrum over the center of the cranial aspect of the subject's head. Movable arm parallel to an imaginary line between the two acromial processes. Stable arm aligned with the movable arm. Instruction to the patient, turn the body on the one side as far as possible, keeping the trunk straight and feet flat on the floor. As the patient moves, the movable arm moves with the movement. Normal range is 0 to 45 degree. Now we are going to perform thoracolumbar rotation with double inclinometer. Patient position, forward flex standing position. Back is parallel to the floor. Inclinometer alignment. Place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T1 and the second inclinometer over the spinous process of S2 vertebrae. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, rotate the trunk as far as possible without moving into extension. Examiner needs to hold the inclinometer against the back during the motion. Note the degrees indicated by inclinometer at the end of the motion. Difference between two inclinometer readings is the rotation range of motion. There are three methods to measure lumbar flexion range of motion. First one is modified Scobar test. Patient position, standing position. Tap alignment, place a first mark at spinous process of S2 vertebrae. Make a second mark 15 cm above the first mark. Align the tap between the superior and inferior marks and measure the distance. Instruction to the patient, bend forward as far as possible while keeping the knee straight. Maintain the tap measure against the back during the motion. At the end of the range of motion, measure the distance between the two marks. The range of motion is the difference between 15 cm and the length measured at the end of the motion. Second one is double inclinometer for lumbar flexion. Patient position, standing position. Inclinometer alignment. Place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T12 and the second inclinometer over the S2. Both inclinometer adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend forward as far as possible while keeping the knee straight. Maintain the inclinometers against the spine during the motion. Note the degrees indicated by inclinometer. Difference between both measurement at T12 level and S2 level is the lumbar flexion range of motion. Third one is single inclinometer for lumbar flexion. Patient position, standing position. Inclinometer alignment. Place the single inclinometer on spinous process of T12. Inclinometer adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend forward through available range of motion while keeping the knee straight and the feet shoulder apart. Maintain the inclinometer at T12 throughout the motion and take a measurement at T12 at the end of the motion. Further, inclinometer placed over the spinous process of S2 vertebrae. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend forward with the examiner, maintain the inclinometer on S2 throughout the motion and take measurement at S2 level. The difference between both measurement at T12 level and at S2 level is the lumbar flexion range of motion. There are three methods to measure lumbar extension. First one is double inclinometer. Patient position, standing position with the feet shoulder width apart. Inclinometer alignment. Place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T12 and second inclinometer over the spinous process of S2. Both inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend backward as far as possible. Maintain the inclinometers against the spine during the motion. Read and record the degrees from both inclinometers at the end of the motion. Difference between both inclinometer readings is the lumbar extension range of motion. Second one is modified scobber test for lumbar extension. Patient position, standing position with the feet shoulder width apart. Tap alignment. Place a first mark at the spinous process of S2 vertebrae. Make a second mark 15 cm above the first mark. Align the tap measure between the first and second mark on the spine and measure the distance. Instruction to the patient, bend backward as far as possible. Measure tap should be placed over the spine at marking level during range of motion. At the end of the motion, record the distance between the superior and inferior marks. The range of motion is the difference between 15 cm and the length measured at the end of the motion. Normal range 15 to 20 degree. Third one is single inclinometer for lumbar extension. Patient position, standing position. Inclinometer alignment. Place single inclinometer over the T12 vertebrae. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend backward as far as possible. Maintain the inclinometer at T12 throughout the motion and record the degrees indicated by inclinometer T12 at the end of the motion. Further, inclinometer placed over the S2 vertebrae. Instruction to the patient, bend backward again. Maintain the inclinometer on S2 throughout the motion and take another measurement at S2. Difference between both inclinometer measurement at T12 and at S2 is lumbar extension range of motion. There are two methods to measure lumbar lateral flexion. First one is double inclinometer. Patient position, standing position with the feet shoulder width apart. Inclinometer alignment. Place one inclinometer over the spinous process of T12 and second inclinometer over the spinous process of S2. Both inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend the trunk laterally while keeping both feet flat on the ground and the knee straight. Read and record the degrees on both inclinometer. Difference between both inclinometer readings is the lumbar lateral flexion range of motion to one side. Repeat the measurement process to measure lumbar lateral flexion range of motion on the other side. Normal range is 25 to 30 degree to each side. Second one is single inclinometer for lumbar lateral flexion. Patient position, standing position. Inclinometer alignment. Place single inclinometer over the T12 vertebra. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend to the side as far as possible without raising the heel of the foot from the ground. Maintain the inclinometer at T12 throughout the motion. Record the degrees indicated by inclinometer at T12 at the end of the motion. Further inclinometer place over the S2 vertebra. Inclinometer is adjusted to 0 degree. Instruction to the patient, bend sideways again. Maintain the inclinometer on S2 throughout the motion and take another measurement. Difference between both measurement is the value of lumbar lateral flexion range of motion.